now move into full mode for our tribute to 200 years of Star Trek. Let's move on. In just a few minutes, that slinky, silky, side-winding Svengali of the sensual spaces, Nichelle Nichols, will be out here. That's your own Lieutenant Uhura, of course. She'll be coming aboard to let down her defence shields, but part one of our tribute comprises of her immediate superior, Captain Kirk himself. You see, William Shatner was in the country this week, and so we had a bit of a dilemma. Do we go and see him and simply talk about Star Trek, or do we do what we generally do when we have huge Hollywood stars in the country, i.e. give them one of our famous but dumb, do you think you're clever, trivia quizzes? Well, we decided for once with Bill, because it was 200 years of Star Trek, we were going to play it straight. That is, until William Shatner let it slip that his obsession is British television. Well, you can't let that pass, and things began to slide. But we did try, so it's 200 years of Star Trek, and here's a little thing called Look, Everyone, It's William Shatner! How you doing?
Not well.
No? Mm-hmm. Well, me and you both, and I didn't want to say that.
It's late.
Yeah.
Tonight, yeah. And jet lag is a strange thing.
When were you in then? Yesterday?
The day before.
Of course, you realise the supreme irony in you having jet lag, of course, and I suppose everyone...
Well, I can understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
You have planet lag.
If it came to it, of all the faces and phases of Star Trek, out of all the crews, who'd win in a fight, do you think?
I think Chekhov would...
Really?
...beat the...
Really?
...piss out of all of us.
You too?
Oh, absolutely.
Of course, the obsession worldwide with Star Trek, the Trek is the whole bit.
Yes.
What is your obsession? What do you think you're pretty hot on?
I play English television all the time.
What do you know about British TV?
A great deal. I have masses of film in my bedroom, and I put in this film in every night. I play English television all the time.
Let me just see if you're not just winding up a tired old British TV crew here. Let's just see if you're not just... Take a look at this. Who was that?
That's Pinky Bird.
It is? Mm-hmm. What was James Bolam's character in The Likely Lads?
Terry Collier.
What was the name of the BBC's disastrous...
Eldorado.
Eldorado? Do you think if you had been in Eldorado, it helped?
Sure. I would have married Fizz and... got around you.
Okay, question five. Listen to this music. What's that show?
Money Program.
How did I have all the engines speak?
He blew it out of his pipes, is what he did.
Let's get tough now, then. Which words and phrases best sum up daytime presenter Mo Dutton?
Ease.
Mm-hmm.
Affability. Mm-hmm. Steady as she goes. That kind of British.
That's the fella. You got it. You know your stuff. Now I'm going to open the. In Wacky Races, match the following drivers with their cars. The Red Max was.
Crimson Hayballer.
That's Professor Pat Bending.
Converticar.
Okay, the Slag Brothers Rock and Gravel drove the.
Bouldermobile.
Yeah, well, that's American show. Let's come back. Do you think wrestling's fixed?
Yes, of course it is.
You think it's fixed? How about those soap powder commercials I do? What do you think about those?
Well, they're as real as Niagara Falls.
You think they're real good for you? Okay, in our office, by the way, our researcher, Danny Dignan, is a Trekkie. He just wants you to acknowledge his existence.
Hey, Dan, how you doing?
Question 14. On the opening titles of the epic BBC series I, Claudius, the art department went nuts and spelled the title all wrong. What did it actually say?
No, don't know.
No.
I, Clavs Daves.
I, Clavs, yeah. Question 15. In the 60s, on Thursdays, what was watched with Mother?
Ragtag and Bobtail.
Question 17. Should Susan Stranks once had a... And there's the buzzer. William Shatner, you got a weighty 15 there. I think a round of applause.
15? I got them 15. All right.
You got
15.
You got them all right so far. Now, listen here. We've already mentioned your film coming up, and I know you've got the books, too, out on the market there.
The Tech War books are out there.
Do you want to blow all that by going for the grand prize
grand
question?
Grand prize question.
Now, let me tell you, it'll be a one-off question.
Yes.
And you'll get all that. All the mentions will remain in the piece.
Yes.
Plus,
yes.
We will see to it that there is a worldwide destruction of every copy of the rather bizarre version you made of Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds. Do you want to go for that question?
Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds is a artistic piece of music that is yet unrecognized.
Sure.
To destroy that is to destroy the Mona Lisa.
So do you want to go for it?
Yes.
Yeah. Ellen Road earlier this season, Tottenham played Leeds in a 1-1 draw. Who scored for Tottenham?
was Teddy Sheringham. It was Teddy Sheringham.
Is this too late to say you shit?
Teddy, everybody gets that wrong. I don't know what it is. So the recording remains in existence. It remains very much alive.
Picture yourself in a boat on a river. Tangerine trees and marmalade sky.
But you still have £35, which you're going to take back with you to Hollywood. Thank you very much. You enjoy yourself here today?
Not really.
There you go. Mr. William Shatner.
What was that guy's name again?
In our office, that was Danny Dignan. He just wanted you to say hello, you know. Yeah.
They all do.
Crazy Klingon cacophony ablaze as we welcome aboard Nichelle Nichol! Ah! Ah, you look... You look... Right, you look... Right, you look... Right, you look good. Ah.
Thank you.
If you would just there, you look great.
Thank you so much.
I didn't see you before the show. Normally I do see people. Knocked our socks off.
Yes, thank you.
William Bill Shatner there. It was a very...
He's brilliant, our Captain Kirk, isn't
he? He is brilliant, our Captain Kirk. And the film crews that were around that hotel...
Bill Shatner's not that brilliant, but Captain Kirk...
Yeah, there is that. you famously don't get on. Is that right?
I get along great with him.
Yeah, go on.
No, this is the truth. And we had a wonderful time on Star Trek. We were one big, happy family. The first year was perfect. Yeah. And then after that, as I say, Bill began to distance himself from the rest of us, and so we let him.
See, I'm not being cheap here, but over in the UK, we actually don't know this. And we're not looking for dishing dirty.
Sure.
But what are the plain facts? You say distancing. You say, what does that mean?
I think he became more self-involved in his own career and more insecure, maybe, I don't know.
Yeah.
But he wasn't the warm, wonderful guy that he was that first year.
I loved.
And he has so much charm that I continued to love him for 20-some years, but decided to tell the truth because he could be a dork, Bill.
There it is! That's the style!
And I still love him.
About your own role, were they imposed upon you, those, I mean, let's face it, real sexy suits, the whole bit. I mean, even this thing with the ear was like such a move.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
How much of that did you think, she's, you know...
It was the fashion of the day, the mini skirt.
Yeah.
And they were very comfortable for me. I thought the guys looked kind of silly with the little ruffle
around
the
actually,
pants.
They did, actually, yeah. There's no good
about
that.
I thought the women's were really cool,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah, I know.
And you were really free to do karate, so nobody messed with you.
There's that. And that earpiece, anything actually coming through that earpiece?
Absolutely. Uhura was ahead of all communications on that ship. And what you never got to see was that there were all these people down in the bowels of the ship who obeyed her in the communication center.
Yeah.
So she could bring in a frequency much higher through this with her...
I'm saying, some people have catchphrases, some people have a bit of business.
Yes.
But just put your finger to your ear again, and I think
yes.
we can... Yeah, look at that, yeah? There it is! Look at that! That's the style. You know, 20 years training and you get an round of applause.
Hailing frequencies open, Captain.
Yeah!
I have saucy command.
There you are, you've got this technology to go beyond the stars and to do warp speed and stuff, but it's still like, you know, British Telecom. I've got Starfleet Command, that's it. The football results are coming. You still have to put the finger in the ear,
yes,
that's nice.
Yes.
Amongst the many remembered highlights of Star Trek was the, I believe, American television's first interracial kiss. Before we talk about that, we've actually got it here. What?
I'm thinking of all the times on the Enterprise when I was scared to death. And I would see you so busy at your command. And I would hear your voice from all parts of the ship. And my fears would fade. And now they're making me tremble. But I'm not afraid. I am not afraid.
Thank you.
see what I'm saying?
Apart from the actual power of it, a common or garden piece of television today, but what were the repercussions of that then?
It was incredible. The concern was at the beginning when we were shooting the scene, and all of a sudden they realize this is a love scene between two people with different colors. Oh my goodness. You know, it's never been done before. And so then
really
the suits came down and everybody discussed it, and finally Gene Roddenberry said, this is ridiculous. Let's shoot it both ways and get it over with.
What was the other way then? Not
without the kiss.
Right.
To their credit, they put the kiss on anyway, because Bill Shatner did the scene over and over, insisted on doing the kiss over and over.
Oh, really?
Over again.
Now I'm beginning to understand a little of the friction. Going
I
out.
Did resist. I did resist. He's a good kisser.
Really?
And yes.
That was the one question you wouldn't answer when I was. Yeah.
Yes, and. And then finally they said, we've only got a little more time, you have to do the other version without the kiss. And Bill, you know, this, because he is crazy, you know, you now know that.
Well, yeah,
he takes me in his arms and he goes, I am not going to kiss you. This they are not good. And then he finally goes, hugs me, and he crosses his eyes in the camera. They didn't know it until the dailies the next day, so they had to use the kiss.
Now, I've got some of these Star Trek merchandise, and I just want to run by you. One second. I think I just dropped to the Russian fella. No, I didn't.
Yeah.
Okay. A lot of the shops there, of course, everywhere you go, there is so much merchandise.
Yes.
And I understand you personally get $100 every time one of these is sold, and there you are.
There I
am. Ladies and gentlemen. This it? Can you pick that up there? There you. Let's actually take this out. You have obviously no control over this kind of stuff. But
yeah.
Hang on. Have you got these yourself?
Of course.
There you are. Would you just? What a shot! That must be such an honor. Having a little figure made of yourself.
And she sang on the show, you know.
Yeah.
She sang beyond on.
Now that's you singing. I can tell because her lips aren't moving. That's you. If you've just tuned in, I know it looks weird, but there's a point to this. Listen to this stuff. Come on, yeah, go on, get it. This thing, I love a lot.
Uh-huh. Yes.
It patches in.
Okay. Uhura to Captain Kirk. Captain Kirk, come in,
please.
I'm
trying it. There... Go ahead, Uhura.
Yes. Sir, I have a subspace message from Starfleet Command. They want us to... haul ass back home.
No,
that wasn't the right.
Uhura, you're aware this is 1966. We can't use that language on the network. But in the meantime, I think you better put your fingers in both ears now, because it's going to get very loud around here when I say, ladies and gentlemen, Nichelle Nichol! Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
Those of you who were at the gig in Watford last night know that teams of men